In mathematics, an irrational number is a real number that cannot be expressed as a ratio of integers, for example, as a fraction, when the numerator and denominator are integers. Therefore, irrational numbers, when written as decimal numbers, do not terminate, nor do they repeat. An irrational number that we have used in the previous units is pi, which is approximately 3.14, but as a decimal, it does not terminate, nor repeat, and therefore it is irrational. Non-perfect square roots have irrational values. Looking at the problem below, we are asked to determine between which two integers the square root lies, then use your calculator to approximate each square root to the nearest thousandths. So first we have the square root of 12. Well, because the square root of 9 equals 3, and the square root of 16 equals 4, and 12 is between 9 and 16, we know the square root of 12 must be between 3 and 4. So we'll say the square root of 12 is greater than 3 and less than 4. And now we'll get our decimal approximation using the calculator. On this calculator, the square root key is second x squared. Then we enter 12, press enter. To round to the thousandths place value, we round to 3 decimal places. Notice how there's a 1 in the 4th decimal place, and therefore we round down. The square root of 12 is approximately 3.464. Notice how this value is between 3 and 4. Next we have the square root of 97. Well, the square root of 81 is equal to 9, and the square root of 100 is equal to 10. Because 97 is between 81 and 100, we know the square root of 97 is between 9 and 10. The square root of 97 is greater than 9 and less than 10. And now we'll get our decimal approximation. So we enter the square root, 97, enter. Notice in the 4th decimal place, or the 10,000th place value, we have an 8, which means you round up, and therefore we increase the 8 in the 1,000th place value to a 9. This value rounds to approximately 9.849. The last example, we have the square root of 57. Because the square root of 49 equals 7, and the square root of 64 equals 8, because 57 is between 49 and 64, we know the square root of 57 is between 7 and 8. We can say the square root of 57 is greater than 7 and less than 8. Going back to the calculator, we will get a decimal approximation for the square root of 57. Second x squared, 57, enter. Notice here in the 4th decimal place, we have an 8, which means you round up. So we add 1 to the 9, which gives us 10. So we need to perform an exchange and increase the 4 by 1. This is approximately 7.550, rounded to the thousandths place value. I hope you found this helpful.